Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting. Yeah, that's right, we're painting, and this time we're using Georgian oils, Dale Rowney Georgian oils, because I bought a hoard of them at a bargain price. They're £3 for boxes of three, so you get three tubes Dale Rowney Georgian oils for £3. That's a pound a tube, which is really cheap. So let me show you what I've got going to start with. I'm just putting in a acrylic outline of the painting I'm going to do today, of the ocean, seascape. Seascapes are all fun to do. They really are. They're exciting to do as well. I really look forward to doing seascapes. I've got these whacking rocks here. So why am I using acrylic to start this off, I hear you ask? What do you mean you didn't ask? Of course you asked. The reason is, it's easy to do. What you could do is you could use some oils and thin it down with paint thinner, and then you could put in your rocks and stuff, put in your sketch, and then it'll dry pretty quickly, and then you can carry on. I decided I'd use acrylic today as my underpainting, so I'm just like using a little bit, spinning my bristles, using it like a watercolour really, not very much. And we'll put in our, so we've got this whacking great rock here, a rock behind it, another rock behind that. We'll have to have water splashes going up because we need to make this look 3D. Oh no, the mixing finger's gone in. You see, I always do this now because of doing a lot of pencil crayon and pastel drawings. I always want to mix things up with my finger. It's become a bit of a habit. Doesn't always work when you're doing oil paints, using diving in there and blending it with your finger. And with oil paint all over your finger. Alright, let's do this wave. So we've got a wave and it's climbing here. Climbing and crashing there. This is where it's turning over the most. This is all going to be frothiness. Maybe we can begin. Maybe there's a beginning of a wave coming along there as well. Yeah, that sort of flattens out there. Now and then I'll put in a little detail just to remind me, like angles and stuff. And then I want to have a good crashing wave here. That crashes there. Wipe that back. I really need it. And then there's a crashing wave here as well. Like I said, I'm using a couple of reference pictures. This can be sort of crashing off. Looking up at things and I'm thinking maybe this wave should be higher. quite low, isn't it? Yeah, I think it should be higher. Just use some water. Just wipe it away. Yeah, I think it should be more like here. Maybe this rock can be further in the water, not there. Maybe that one there. You don't have to do this stage if you don't want to. I think it is a useful one though. Useful stage, because then you can move things around and you can go, I don't really like that, and then move it. I just felt it needed, the wave needed to be higher. So it crashes. Crashing down this coming along here. Something like that. And this just giving me an idea of the angles of things. Something like that, that would work. Maybe. But then I really want this to be further forward as well now. You can't really see it there. This is like the distant headland, so we'll just do that a bit lighter than the sky when we get to it. And then the base. Going down here. Something like that. Kind of goes like this. Trying to sort of combine a couple of images that I've got. Let's do more like there. That wave can sort of go like that. Sort of crash down like there. There's a wave like there as well. Yeah. That'll do for our initial sketch. Now I'll just give my palette a wipe down and then I'll get some oil paints on and we'll get painting. Hello, welcome back, and let me show you what I've got on my tray, my palette. I've got some Hooker's Green, Cobalt Blue, Ivory Black, Cadmium Yellow, and Vermillion Red. And then I've made this grey tone, I've made two versions of it, using Cobalt Blue and Ivory Black and White, And then I put a little bit of vermilion in just to warm it up a tiny bit. And let's get started. So I'm using some Winsor & Newton Liquin for as my medium. You can use whatever you've got, doesn't really matter. It's just to thin the colour a little bit. The colour's quite a dryish one. I always have baby wipes next to me because it cleans your fingers. And I'm constantly getting paint on me. Right, let's get started. I'm getting some of this grey colour on the brush. Show you. Just loading both sides. I've got some of the medium as well. Just thins the paint down. And I want to start greying down the sky a bit. It's one of those days where the sea and the sky almost blends together in the background. Using my nice and cheap oils. You know, they say it's a bargain at £1 a tube. That's what I say anyway. These are they're not artist quality paints, but a lot of artists do use them. At the end of the day, you use what you got. You can get some bargain paints, you can create paintings using them, and that's great, isn't it? You can have fun and enjoy yourself doing the painting, then that's all that matters really. You could use liquid clear doing this if you wish. You could liquid clear the whole canvas and then you can put your paint straight on. And you'll probably find it goes on better, a bit smoother. If I was using the Bob Ross oils, I'd be doing that. I'd be putting some liquid clear on just to make it canvas slicker. Easier on your arm. And these paints are a little dry as well, that's why I put a little liquid in with it. Don't need much medium though. Okay, we've got our sky in. Now, I'm going to use... Just wipe my brush a little bit. Just moving the colour from the middle of the palette. Bit of palette maintenance. Keeping your area clean. Keeping your brushes clean. Keeping yourself as clean as possible is a good idea. Right, we've used that one that I made, which was Ivory Black, Cobalt Blue, and a little bit of Vermillion. And then there's another one over here, which is the same mixture, but it's got less white in it and a little less vermilion in it as well. It has got a bit in there, so I might use part of that and part of that other one, the lighter one. Just put it together to make a middle. Yeah, it sort of makes a middle tone, so I've used a bit of that and a bit of that. A bit of the white, a bit of the blue, blue white. You'll see what I mean. So let's put in a rock there. Rock there. You see what's happening is because it's quite light. It's not that far away from the sky in colour. It has a recession to it. It goes backwards. So if you're using a colour that's close to the sky colour for your background, your eye will instantly look at it and go, that's quite far away because it blends in with the sky. It's a nice little trick. Maybe there's another rock over there. I don't know. Just make things up as I go along. Just give my brush a wipe. So we use that other colour again for the water. That there, something like that. Doesn't matter if you go over the lines. I like this brush. This is a Bob Ross. A Bob Ross floral brush. Can't say I'm much of a floral painter, but I do like this brush. Just grabbed a bit of a darker colour then. Just to show that there is a gradual change in tone there. Do the same over here actually. Grab a little bit of the darker, go about behind the rock there. See there. Give the brush a quick wipe. And grab a bit of the lighter. Bring that in and then you can go down to the darker and blend it together. See? Easy. You're wondering, could you do this with acrylics? Yes, you could. We say you have to paint slightly different materials. The thing with oils, they blend so nicely. Oh, they taste so good. No, they don't. It's kind of the taste and it's not, I don't know, it's hard to explain. You can almost taste the goodness of it. Okay, let's change the subject before I sound a little crazy. Okay, let's just get a bit of dark on there as well. Okay, let me see if I've got that out right. Just sort of sitting back a little bit. Let me just put that in there. Because although this blends together, I do want to have a bit of a line. I'll just pick a bit more of that darkish colour again and I'll just dance it around a bit. Not blending it that much, just to indicate movement in the water. Forget about that bit. Might not show up much, but still, best not forget. Okay. And then what I could do, what I'm thinking of doing now, thinking where's the sun? Got to think about that, otherwise none of this is going to work. Say the sun is off the canvas, but tap in some light bits. Don't know if these will show up on camera. I'll use the paint a little thicker so you can see. It's just so you can see some little actions in the background. Anyway, that'll do. It's the background. Don't matter, does it? Right, I'm just throwing a little bit more of this blue. I'll show you. I'm just grabbing a bit more blue and I'm sticking it in this colour. Because I want this one. This rock here. To come forward a bit. To about there. Something like that. It's got the wave crashing over there. And then, using that grey, that mixture for the sky, we could actually underpaint the water as well. With a middle version. In between that and in between that. That's what that looks like. Crash. Maybe it needs to be a little bit whiter. Just so there's a separation. Yeah, it's a bit there, isn't it? You can see it. Big crash. Oh, yes. It's good fun, isn't it? So I do enjoy painting, especially Seascape. Something I want to do, just as I'm looking, I'm thinking, why don't I put a little bit of yellow in my white, just a little bit, he says. Don't want my white, because I don't want my white to be white. I just want it to have a tint, so tint it with yellow. Just mixed it up, bit of yellow in with the white. Clogged my brush up, so I'm just using my knife to get the paint off. Right. So get some paint. Get some paint and the highlight. Let's have a look. It's sort of splashing here. And here. washing and splashing over. Just gonna grab this little brush. We use this brush like it's a 2-inch brush, and we just blend that a little bit. It's really soft, this one is. It's another cheapo special, but there's nothing wrong with that, is there? Well, you don't mind using cheapo stuff. I don't always, sometimes I do buy expensive paints as well. Yeah, that's quite good. Quite like that. Let's grab a little bit of this white on this brush, this other brush. Just tapping it, and I just want to tap it up this. Just to lighten it a little bit. Yeah. That's a bit better. So we're managing to keep this all quite muted and background, which is good. Back here, let's do this rock as well. I picked up a little bit of that yellow. Well, I haven't washed my brush. You've seen that. Go in this rock. Probably a little bit too light, isn't it? Yeah, that's better. About like that. And then there's this rock here. I've gone into a little bit of black as well, look. Not much. Just to make a darker colour. I do like this brush. Okay. Just throwing in the colour. A little bit of cobalt blue, a little bit of black, and a little bit of this greyish white mixture. Just sort of sitting back and looking, and I'm thinking of separating areas a bit more. You can do this with a smaller brush if you wish. You don't have to use this brush. Use whatever you've got. Just sort of separate that a bit at the top. Maybe get a little bit of that light colour that we used earlier. Make a little bit of a highlight on it. On the rock. And there. Yeah, I think that'll do for now. We can always work on that bit more later. Yeah. Got a bit of that colour on there as well. Not on this one. But there's a rocking point of that there. Yeah. Now then, we need to start thinking forwards. The closer you get, the more colour there is. And I want there to be a bit more deeper colour in this foreground. And that would mean, just need to move this white. Moving a few things on my palette. Cleaning the middle up again. I always do that. Clean the middle area out. So you can stick your paint there. And then you can go again. Okay, so not this area. Now this area would have a bit more sea colour in it, so you can use this dull colour again. Let me just show you. This dull colour, this light bluey greeny colour. You can bring that forward, put a bit of blue in it. I'm adding a bit more colour now, a bit of green in it maybe. A little more green. Let's see what that looks like. You can test it and go. Yeah, I quite like it. I think it's not blue enough though. I think it's a bit too green. Let's go for this one. I prefer that one. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to dance this colour around here. And I'm using these little strokes on purpose to make it look like water without even putting any white on yet. And I've not mixed the colour up, I've not really, you know, got the colour and mixed it like a madman. I don't know why that made me laugh so much. I'm not sure. I don't know where I got that from. You know when you see, well, I actually did it, to be fair. You get painters that get so frustrated that they're mixing their paints and their rah, 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 and they go crazy. Like aggressive painting and mixing your paints angrily. And nothing's going right for you. The painting's going wrong, everything's going wrong. And you just get more and more annoyed. Yeah, it's not the way to be. You want to be relaxed. And you want to take it stage by stage. Work on it slowly and enjoy it. So I'm just picking up some of this background colour. Gonna sort of dance it around in here. Sort of create the shift in tone from the background to closer to the mid-ground really. Mid-ground now. Middle ground. Looking for the little holes that I left, and I'm gonna put the grey in there. I want to leave some of these bits. This side's looking pretty good, isn't it? It's getting there. Isn't it good to use oils? I do like using acrylics as well, to be fair. It's just Something about oils. Got magic to them. What are we doing? Oh yeah, we needed a little bit more blue in the colour. Because I wanted to create a wave here, so... messed it up. Went a bit too crazy there. Don't want there to be too much going on. If you have that situation, stop yourself. Go, no, don't do that. And then you're back. We can come back with some white in this afterwards. Oh, I see what I was gonna do. There's a bit of a issue. This would cast quite a dark shadow underneath, and it's not, from what I see, looks dark enough, so. We'll darken it a little bit. Getting the contrast right is, you know, it's tricky. You might not get it right first time. Oh, that's a bit too blue. Quick, wipe the brush. Let's mix that in. Yeah, right. A bit of blue in the shadow colour. Just get a bit more of the light colour now. So I've killed it a bit. Smooth operation. Remember to think like the sea. Sometimes just pushing the colour works. Get that movement going. Just tapping a bit of colour on now. Okay. I'll do. Now I want to do the same over here. This water. So you can blend it a little bit of that as well. I might just bring it forward. Grabbing a bit of the sunshine colour, I'm going to go looking a little. A bit of water has come through and it's splashing up some of these rocks. Some light hitting over here as well. We can bring a little licks colour. Using the brush at an angle, it's quite a bit of movement. And I can use my other brush, my softer brush. I can just sort of flatten it out a little bit in areas, and I can have a look, see what I like, what I don't like, and I can come back and go over it again with the bluish colour. Yeah, it's looking alright though, isn't it? It's looking like water. I want to put a rock here. I'll use that dark colour. I'll use that dark colour that we did this one, except I put a tiny bit of red in. This brush is another cheapo. Seems to be a pattern going on. All my equipment seems to be cheapo equipment. you guessed it. Mostly it is. Right there. Let's get a bit of water going up. That one's kind of lost there. This one we can put a little bit more dark on there. Just so you could see it. Okay, where did we get up to? Okay, we've got this big rock here. Got a wave here. These brushes, we'll use a different brush. I don't want to mess that one up because I'm enjoying it. I'll use this brush. I'll use for the foreground rock, the big rock. Use some black. Oh, I need to make him a bit of a change of to change my palette up a little bit and my nice sea colour things moving. I have some okay, what I've done is, sorry I couldn't show that, it was just a mixture of black, blue, green and red. I just mixed it up, made like a greeny, I put more red in it actually, make the rock a bit warmer. So yeah, it's just a muddy mess of a colour. Let's have a look at it. It's dark, which is what we wanted, and it'll be darker than this one, which is definitely what we wanted. It's going on quite well. Thinking, shall I have a little bit of medium on it, make it go on better, but it's going on alright. Rock. Think like a rock. Think like a sharp rock. In the water here. It's sort of a way of making the water a little bit transparent by putting the rock colour in it, so then you can see some of it through the water. Yeah, I kind of do need a bit of medium now. Just got a little bit of the Liquin medium, just to aid me in the flowing process. Yeah, it helps the paint flow a bit better, and it helps it dry quicker as well, which is a bonus. Billy bonus. This is quite dark, isn't it? This has got contrast. This rock is saying I'm in front. I'm in front of this one, I'm in front of that one, I'm in front of them all. Okay, like I said, it's a dark in there, and then we can have a bit of white, just for a bit of white in there. Make a highlight colour, and maybe we can just sort of indicate bits and bobs. Just throw a bit of blue in that colour now. I like it needed to be a bit more blue. Don't forget, you can always test the colours you're using. Always test them. You can have a little canvas or a bit of canvas roll beside you, and you can always put that, you know, put a little bit of colour on there. And you can look back and go, is that what I want? Is that what I really, really want? Okay. Okay, we're starting to get quite a nice depth now. Depth and distance. Which is good. Right. We need to start working on this wave. And we also need to do that. Behind one. Don't like that there. Get rid of that. And that. Yeah, I prefer that. Right. The next little tip before I start whacking in this wave is do the painting as a whole. Don't do the painting as sky separate, middle ground separate, foreground separate. You want to do the whole thing, so the whole painting comes together together. You want it to come together. Together. So I'm just using a light blue. Just want to create a bit of a... The water has gone... I did that a bit too high there. Dropped. It's the dreaded area where my light shines. Let's just darken it a bit again. Right, let's make it a bit better and have a piece that juts out there. Yeah, I like that. Okay. We don't make mistakes. We make unbelievable bad ones. So let's think about this wave again. Thinking about the wave. Do I want the wave to be like? I want it to have that light area in the wave. So, I want to be there. Yes, there. You know that light. Seascape, and people will look at your painting and go, whoa, that looks amazing, that bit of light. And you say, well, hang on that, Joe. It's very hard to capture the light there. That if you do that, then you do the same as me. Tell them it's hard, really hard. To be fair, it is. When you first start painting, it is hard, to be honest. Okay. So enough further, enough talk. My painting. So we want to need to start bringing things darker, making things a lot darker than they were, because we're close now, and in this close area the water is fuller. That bit there. That bit there wants to be quite dark. And I've got this wave here, so I want the dark area here as well. I've got this crashing over. And a bit of dark in these areas as well. And choose here and there where I want it to be a bit darker. Yeah, okay. So we've gone a bit darker. There is a reason, honestly. I'm just going to blend these two together here. Just spinning the bristles. The same as you'd normally do it. Okay. Give him a brush a wipe. Okay. Soften that a bit. Moving my image. My image to help me. Oops. Nearly dropped everything then. So I'm just wiping my brush on my baby wipe to get it pretty clean. And then I go for the wipe on the paper towel after that. So we need a nice colour for our underside of our wave, so I'm going to use a sort of a grey, like that. It's just blue, dark red and white. Might have got a dark black in there as well. So it's basically our original colour, you know, just using it again. So I want to be here. A little bit too grey. I want it to be a bit more blue than that. So a bit some blue. Yeah, that's better. So we can start looking at this. Like I said, I am using a photo for reference, just to help me out a bit, really. I do have a tendency to veer off and start creating my own, which is what, that's alright, because then you create your own picture then, and you don't have the stress of having to copy something exactly, not unless you're doing a commission, of course. Yeah, that's good. There. It's crashing over there. Might have got this colour going actually. I might get this wave going as well. Crashing over. Quite dark with all this water, so I have to use a fairly dark shadow colour. Wave and then another wave and then another one. Let's start the one here, but never mind. We'll carry on with that in a minute. Okay. So where have we got to? What are we doing? We need a nice. Oh, there it is. We've got our little pile of colours dotted around. Got a nice light blue. It's basically the colour we used earlier there. Just wanted to put a strip there. We've got this just need to... make it look like it's moving a bit. Probably gonna have to come back with some darker glue actually. It's not the right colour. I want a bit more blue in it. A bit more blue. Let's just grab some bit of blue on the brush and to go to a smaller brush. It's getting there. Just want to get that dark there. That dark. And there. Yeah, that's a bit there. I'll go for a smaller brush. Swipe my hands again. We'll go back to our bigger brush when we start doing all the froth. I tried to do as much as I can using the bigger brush, but there comes a time. And the small brush is the better. So I'm just making a light blue colour. Get our wave. It's all like that. I've properly loaded this brush. It's got quite a lot of paint on it, and I'm just gonna try and get this shape here. Splash there. And there. So that splash has helped us. Yeah. A bit. Of course we've got this light that's going through there as well. I'm going to soften this a bit. Okay, I want it a little bit more. Very strange the way the water looks when it's going up on a wave. I would have thought the whole thing would look like it's curving, but it's not. It looks like it's more like climbing. Bright on there just to separate it really. Like that. Okay. Now I'm going to go back with the really dark colours, pure colour. Because I'm kind of losing that pure colour. Okay, that's a bit better. Try and get that. Darker here. Some light. I feel like I haven't spoke for ages. Sorry, I was concentrating there. There's light sort of going through the wave. Some of that pure colour, let's bring it there. Okay. Now my hands look a bit like the Incredible Hulk's. Just give them a quick wipe. And have a sit back and have a look. See if we've got the sea looking a bit better. I wouldn't say it is better. There's still improvements to be made, and there always is when you're doing a painting. But it's looking pretty good. Okay, let's start adding some splashing. Ooh, that's a bit too yellow. Yowza. Get rid of that. Too yellow. Way too yellow. I'm just going to make a bit of a palette change. So I need to get rid of some of the colours that I don't think I'll be using again. Red. I'm not going to be using red now. There was a lot of yellow and white, which I can't use because it's too yellow. But there is a lot of area. Okay. So what do we need? We need a light colour. Use our sky colour with a dot of yellow in it. Just using the sky colour with a dot of yellow, because this can be stage one of the highlight really. So we've got it turning over here. Flashing down. Crashing. Get some splashing going on. Got this splashing here and then there. A little bit below, and then we can use this brush just to sort of blend it together a little bit. Now, a little bit of pure white. I think I'll use a different brush as well to get my splashing going. I'll use this round brush. Get some of the white, tiny bit of the yellow. This will be our brightest. Oops, some of the hairs are falling out of this brush already. Create our lightest of the lights. I'm sort of using a flicking stroke here. Just picking out areas that the light probably hit more. Thinking ocean thoughts. it is funny. Thinking like you're the ocean. Yeah, I'm all wet. Okay, so I'm just creating the splash ends. This is all crashing over. Yeah, it's something really annoying. Whenever I set up to do a film myself doing a painting, there's always a lot of noise. I don't know if there's always that noise or it's just because I'm doing painting. I notice it more maybe when I'm painting and I want it to be quiet because I want you to be able to relax and hear everything. Okay, while I've got this white going, I'm going to create a little splash up here. And up here. Some little extra little details in. Okay. Just sort of softening that yellow that I put in earlier. Okay, and that can come down to there. Yeah, that'll do. And then I get my original colour and can sort of do something like that there. Sort of crashing down there and then you can start putting in the darker areas underneath. You can kind of look and sort of use your reference picture or start making your own idea of how the water's going to turn over and flow. That. I feel like it should go backwards a bit more. I just want a bit more there. It's the back and forth game now. I need a bit more. Okay. I think maybe that's a little bit too much. It is there. So that's all splashing over. Maybe we can go into dark colours. Bit in here. up some of the blues and greens. Just sort of bring that in here. Okay. The squeaking dog. Let's quickly stop recording and let the dog out. I'm just using a light colour now. A little white, bit of blue. Just sort of creating that shape underneath the crashing of the wave. It also needs to be like little bits of too dark. Little bits of colour. In amongst those areas. It's okay, we'll be okay with that. I wasn't planning on this to be a very long lesson, but it does happen when you're trying to paint something, it's got a bit more detail. Does take a bit longer. I've got this wave here. Just go in there with the colour now. Just darken that off a bit. And we'll create our shadow colours here. This wave has turned over. It might change things a little bit. Because that's come. It's going to start flowing this way, isn't it? So when I sit further away, I can sort of see the flow a bit better. See that it's all coming this way. So I'll come in, splash. Get out of there the white and blue. And sort of drag a few bits. Cross. start working on this. I feel like this one could be a bit smaller than the back one. Maybe I can have it good enough to there. Just get some sea colour on the brush to get to this bit now. Blue and green. Might have to put something behind there. I'll hold it for a minute. I don't think I'm blocking. No, I'm not blocking the view. Apologies for my arm. Just want to block this colour in at the base. Had noise galore at the moment. Okay. Okay, so that's okay, and then I think the best way for me to do this. Of create those dark bits underneath again. Areas where it's sort of turning over. Okay. Now I'll grab some white. Splash. Using quite a lot of paint here. Just sort of splashing it. Thinking about where the light's probably hitting. That's typical. Someone's now working on their shed. Can't catch a break today. Just use this white that's on my brush and just create some little action in the water. Just sort of mix that up a little bit there. Okay. I'm just gonna create a darker colour. Do the same sort of thing. To show where the water's falling, how it's crashing. Just sort of sitting back, having a look, seeing what I can do, and putting some little glints of light over here. There's some there as well. Just using my finger, I'm just going to soften this. Of any soften that line as well. Okay. Yeah, I think that shows quite a bit. Give you a good idea. A splash there, splash on there. Give you a good idea of what to do, to have a go at your painting. Something with a bit of detail. A bit of fun. Well, thanks very much for watching this one. Hope to see you at another one. I could keep going with this forever until really until I've messed it up. So we'll get a little bit of a yellow highlight, and I'll just stick a light bit there and there. I'm just going to soften that on the finger. And I'll call that one. Hello and welcome to part two of this video. I say part two because I left this painting and in the last couple of days I've looked at it and thought I could improve this. So I thought, shall I improve it? Yeah. But let's film it as well, so you can see. The reality is, when I'm painting, I look at my painting a lot, and then I'm thinking on ways to improve things. And first way, I'm just getting some of this cobalt blue and hooker's green, which I have to say is a nice mix of colours for the ocean. Some people only use colours that are transparent because it helps to create that sea effect a bit better. I just wanted a bit more dark under there, under that bit there. The oil paint has started already. It's on my hands. So, I'm just sort of thinking about the areas where it's quite dark. So I'm going to put a little bit of colour. As you can see, it's been a couple of days and the paint is still wet. Fantastic, right? If you're working wet and wet, then yeah. If you want to use dry paint, then you have to wait. So I'm just adding this darkness under here and the shadow, because there'll be a shadow there on that wave. And I'll just make a light colour, look. Just getting some blue and this green and then white. I want a darker colour for this underside of the wave. See what that looks like. It's probably a little too dark. Throwing a bit more white. Just a bit more white there. See how that looks. Sort of blend of this. That's a bit better. I want to create that darkness there. Shadow. There's not much light hitting, so it would be quite dark, really. Helps. It is dark. It helps to make the light look light, you know. Just picking out areas. Should be darker. Improving things a bit. hopefully. If you've got white on like I have, doing it in this way, then you can always load your brush, start at the bottom where the it'd be darkest, and then work up. Load my colour again, go at the base, and then start working up again. Yeah, I think that does look better in my mind. I'm just sort of flicking a bit of white now, just grabbing a bit of white. I didn't clean my brush, just sort of flicking it on the top just to create that movement. Little trick, if you're wanting a darker colour and you've just used lighter, you just give it a wipe with a paper towel and you can go back to your dark. And it stays dark. You don't have to like mix more colour in to make it darker. It's the beginner's tip really. You probably already know. Get some more colour in here. This is way too light in here. Using a bit of this green, I think I'll put some areas on the top of the wave. Like there's some more blue, darkness. So the idea is that this one has rolled over and sort of finished a bit. I'm using brush strokes to create the movement. I didn't really do that before. I'm not really sure why. See, sometimes it's best to leave something and then come back to it. Just think about how this is crashing over it like that. I'm using the white. It looks more like it's crashing over now. And you can use thicker paint if you wish. You don't have to. I think when we're beginners... No, I still consider myself a beginner really. I know I've got a lot to learn. When we first start, we don't use enough paint. I added a bit of yellow into my colour now. Just a little bit. Okay, just sit back, have a look. Nice. When you're using a lot of paint, you need to be kind of light pressure basically. You need to use fairly light pressure and you just let the paint fall off the brush. Down here. Okay, and sit back, have a look. I think what would be good, grab the liner brush now, just get a little bit of this bluey greeny colour that we mixed on the liner, just sort of create a bit of a line underneath that area. Sort of a separator, only very faintly, where it crashes. I want to break that bit up there as well. Alright, leave it at that. I don't want to do too much in the background really. Otherwise, this will mix up with my finger. Just going to get a little bit of this liquin, just a little bit. A bit of paint on my liner, so I just put a tiny bit of liquid on the brush and then put that in with my colour. Load my brush. Certain areas I want to sparkle. I want that light to sparkle down the wave. And then back here, be nice to have some little detail, little little blip blips. And actually, back there, that needs to be a bit darker. So let's get some of this same colour, pretty much as the under part of this wave. I'll darken this here. Just get a bit more colour. A bit more of the blue. To get that water darker over here, because this rock is covering the light. You need to express that there. A little bit there, and I was like, that doesn't really work. A little bit of this pure colour will create an indication of the wave. Using the darker colour, you can just sort of throw it in to make the indication of more action. Okay, this is more to what I had in mind originally. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. I hope it taught you something. Gets you excited about doing a painting. Always a game of light and dark, isn't it? Didn't paint around. Okay. So this bit's already turned over, so I'll create some splashes. Get a little bit of this yellow and just sort of maybe I'll remove some of that actually. Okay, right, we'll call this done then. I think we'll work out what we're going to do next. I might do something more cartoon-like, maybe with my Copic pet markers or something. Not sure yet. But anyway, thanks very much for watching this one, and hope it helps you out. And I'll see you at another one. Cheers, bye.